Hello people, it's me, Ginny Metheral. I am a witch of several generations. I practice the old ways and traditional magic. I have learnt my craft through being taught by my family to start with, and then through books learning, communication with the world of spirit. They have a lot of knowledge, if not all of it after all, and varying other people along my path of life. So today's video is about making your own moon water. I have wanted to make this video for a while because I refer to moon water all the time. I use it almost on a daily basis. It is one of the most frequent items in a witch's arsenal that I would use. Moon water, of course, is water that has been blessed by the moon, but there are lots of different ways that you can look at this. So we're going to look at what moon water is, what it's used for, how to make it, and also complications about making it. Do you have enough moon after all? The moon, that wonderful celestial orb, holds an immense amount of power. After all, it pulls all the water in the world towards itself. You know, think of the tides. And therefore we consider it, in fact, not even consider, we understand the moon to have power over all water. That's including the water in our bodies, the water in the sea, the water under the earth, the water everywhere. And the moon is loved and beloved of water. This has been known forever. Every ancient culture, wherever you look in the world, will have a moon worshipping ceremony, and that moon worshipping ceremony would have involved water. Now, I'm not asking you to worship the moon. I am asking you to honour, respect and love, especially if you are going to ask the moon to bring down her blessings and help you. The moon can impart her strength and grace into water. This strength and grace will imbue itself within that water and therefore bring extra moon energy to your spells. And what is this moon energy? Well, this moon energy makes your spells stronger, more accessible, easier to create. If you use moon water as opposed to regular water, there's already energy in that water that you have asked the moon to give you. You can then direct that energy in the water towards whatever part of the spell it needs to go to. I appreciate that that might be a little complicated, but hopefully by the end of the video, you shall understand all. So you can make moon water at any point during the moon's progress through the skies, apart from the 3 days that the moon is dark. And what you do is you simply take your bowl, you fill it with spring water, preferably not water covered in chemicals like chlorine and fluoride or whatever it is that comes out of the tap nowadays. Buy some good bottled water, place that in your bowl, and leave the bowl to be bathed overnight outside by the moon. Now, many of you have said that they're unable to get outside, so a windowsill and an open window works just as well. However, you might not have an opening window to do this with. So the next option is therefore to leave your water on a windowsill at night in the direction that the moon is there. However, you also might not be able to do that. So therefore, you could leave your water in a bowl on a windowsill facing north. It will work. The difference between leaving your bowl of water outside is that it gets an immediate response from the moonlight that bathes it, because you're going to cast a spell to ask the moon. If you have no moonlight directly onto it, then it just takes a little longer for the energy to filter down. Once you have placed your bowl of water to be blessed by the moonlight, you need to ask the moon to grant you this grace. People have different methods of asking the moon. I would always suggest that the best thing to do is to make sure that you are well purified. So do a nice smudge or a incense burning ceremony, or have a bath. That's a very good way of doing a cleansing ceremony before you ask, and get rid of all that negativity. And go to the moon and, like a child in all innocence, ask the moon to bless your water with her grace and strength. Be polite, be clear, fuzzy ideas get fuzzy results, because you can ask the moon to bless your water in different ways. For example, I would like to do a spell, which is a healing spell, and I'm going to use some herbs from my garden to help with this. I'm going to brew them into a tea using water. Now I know that I'm going to do this, and so therefore I can say to the moon, "Dear moon, please could you grant your grace and strength into this spell so that I can use it for healing." And the moon will direct her energy into that water in such a way that it becomes a healing water. Likewise, if you're doing a spell of protection and you're, say, sprinkling water around your boundaries, you can ask the moon to bless and grace your water and imbue in its strength and protective qualities, and the moon will do so. Moon water, it can be used in so many different aspects, and so therefore when you're making the moon water, you need to be clear about what aspects you are required to be put into the water. If you're going to use the water for dark magic, you're not going to get very far. You'll get some strength, but this will fight with any dark magic that you might be using. So I wouldn't suggest using moon water. This is a white magic ritual, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Moon water is always for the white witch. Now, when you're making your moon water, you might not have any specific spells in mind. I often don't. I just make a batch of moon water because I've run out. And so therefore, I just ask the moon to bring down her strength and grace and bless the water so that it will help all spells that I use it with come to fruition. The next thing is to talk about the phases of the moon and when's good to make it. Traditionally, you're told to make moon water at the full moon. This is because the moon is at their brightest and most powerful. And when the moon is at her brightest and most powerful, she can imbue the moon water with whatever qualities you have asked for very quickly. If you make your moon water when the moon is waning, then it doesn't make much of a difference. It just means you need to wait longer for the moon to bless to get the same strength that she would give you on a full moon night. It is as simple as that. And the nights where it is a dark moon, don't make moon water because it's a bit pointless. The moon can't get to it. New moon water, however, does have a slightly different energy. For the energy of the new moon, you're looking at spells for the young, spells for children. So to bathe a newborn babe with the new moon water is a beautiful ritual, giving the babe strength and courage and the light of a new moon. The moon ages then throughout the month as she waxes and grows to a full moon. And so if you think, well, I've got a teenager, therefore you need a moon that's a halfway point, don't you? And if you are a teenager and you want to do a moon water spell, make it during a halfway point of the moon's waxing and waning, as this is most aligned with your energy. If you're in, or consider yourself, in your prime of life. I don't think I'm in my prime of life. I think my prime was a few years ago. But however, in my prime of life, that is when I would use a full moon water for me personally, because the energies are most combined. And then as the moon wanes, those are the time that you would make moon water to deal with the middle age and coming to the elderly. It's a much more softer, gentle style of energy. This energy differential is very subtle. So it is sort of advanced witchcraft, really, if you know the time of the month to make the moon water for the spell that you are doing. You really have to think about these sort of spells in advance and wait. But for your general average, daily, normal spellcraft, the moon water from any time is perfectly acceptable. The one thing I would say though is that make sure that the water that you use is clean, whatever it is. If you're going to drink it, make sure it's drinkable water. So the uses of moon water are many and varied, and so I thought I'd give you a few ideas of what to do with your newly made moon water. If you have made moon water aligned with the moon and your time in life, then it's a really lovely idea to add a cupful of that moon water to your bath with some rose quartz and quartz crystals. This is invigorating, cleansing, and also calming. So if you're anxious and stressed, It can invigorate you to look at the world anew, yet calm that anxiety.
Moon water is also particularly useful when making tea spells. So you might use the dried ingredients from your garden and add moon water to it.
It just adds that extra to the spell. So to recap, how to make moon water. Give yourself a quick cleanse and purification ritual. Get some spring water. Place it in a glass bowl outside in the moonlight. Ask the moon to cast her blessings down upon the water, putting any specifics that you would require into that spell. Leave the bowl out 10 minutes in bright moonlight, a bit longer if you're on a windowsill not facing direct moonlight, and then you are free to use your moon water. If you've got any questions or thoughts about this, do leave them in the comments below. I respond to every single query that you will have. Don't forget, my coven meeting's coming up any moment now. Do go to patreon.com/Ginny Metheral for further details and come and join us. And if you like this video, do give me a like and a subscribe. And I will see you in my next one.